I wanna be a billionaire so bad. Buy all other things I never had. I wanna be on the cover of Forbes magazine. There you go. There's a line.
Be everything you want. Hey girl, let me talk to you. If I was your boyfriend, never let you go.
Justin, you've been around the world. You've accumulated almost 20 million Twitter followers, sold millions and millions of records, and now it's venture capital.
Yes.
Tell me how you got involved in startups and why.
Well, I just wanted everything that I do, I try to have a charitable component. And I do music, and I try to leave a lot of the business up to this guy over here. I just think it's important to be a part of things that are starting up. Like when Spotify, I went to the launch of Spotify, and that was really cool. And this other company we're working with, Wetopia, which is all based around charity and giving back. So everything I do, I try to add a charitable component. So.
Tell me a little bit more about Wetopia and how that whole thing came about.
Well, Wetopia, I really had no clue about it or what it was, and he was kind of explaining to me it's kind of like Farmville, but like everything is all like it's money going to real people in need, so that's why I really wanted to get involved. It's fun, but it's also helping the world.
He's extremely savvy for his age, and I think people have seen this, how he just handles everything with the amount of pressure, because no one's ever been this young and this famous before, especially as a solo artist. And especially in a world where you have Twitter, Facebook, camera phones, everyone's watching. And I think what's interesting about what he's done with his, charity work, he's actually teaching a lesson in which for-profit businesses should study, that whenever a for-profit business has a nonprofit component or a charitable component, they actually make more money in the long run because the consumer feels more comfortable being involved.
And in a lot of ways, I think the tech investment makes a lot of sense for you, especially because, in many ways, you're like the first social media superstar.
For me, yeah, it's like social media was helped launch my career. Without the internet and without YouTube, I wouldn't have gotten a chance to put my music out there and have people hear it.
What other musicians and entertainers in general would you say you're kind of modeling your career after, both in terms of music and in terms of business?
I mean, for me, it's like it's only one person. It's like, everything that I do is kind of modeled after Michael Jackson, so. If I was your boyfriend, never
let you go. You know, Michael Jackson's also, I think a lot of people don't really give him full credit, but was a pretty shrewd businessman too. Tell me a little bit about that. Is that part of the kind of emulation model there?
I've created a monster.
Well, he's always teaching me things, and he wants me to be knowledgeable about my business and know what I'm actually doing, and not just be one of those artists who just lets everybody else take care of it. He wants me to actually be a mini mogul myself.
Right.
I think at the end of the day, a lot of artists, things get messed up because people come in from the outside and create fear. And they create fear because the artist doesn't have enough knowledge about their own business. So they come in and say it should be like this or it should be like that. So Justin spends at least 1 hour every week with myself, with the business manager, with the lawyer, going over scenarios in business and learning and, dissecting it. And he always knows the right questions to ask, which is pretty impressive. Even at 15, he was like that. I think he'll never be fearful in this business because he'll have a firm understanding of it. If I was your boyfriend.